Ever wondered if a computer could think like a human? Could a machine ever truly mimic human intelligence? This intriguing question was at the heart of a bold idea known as the Turing test. In this video, we're going to analyze just that. Stick around to discover how this test challenges the boundaries between human and machine intelligence. First, we should learn a bit about the man behind the Turing test, Alan Turing. Alan Turing was a pioneering British mathematician and computer scientist who is often regarded as the father of modern computing. Born in 1912, Turing made significant contributions during World War II by developing the bomb machine, which was instrumental in breaking the Enigma code used by the Nazis. His work laid the foundations for computer science and artificial intelligence. Turing proposed the concept of the Turing test, a criterion for determining a machine's ability to exhibit intelligent behavior equivalent to or indistinguishable from that of a human. His legacy still continues to inspire and shape the fields of mathematics, computing, and artificial intelligence. Now let's see what the Turing test is and why it is so important. As mentioned, the Turing test, proposed in 1950, is a measure of a machine's ability to exhibit intelligent behavior indistinguishable from that of a human. In the test, a human judge interacts with both a machine and another human without knowing which is which, solely through written communication. If the judge cannot reliably distinguish between the human and the machine is said to have passed the test. The Turing test is important because it provides a foundational benchmark for evaluating artificial intelligence, prompting discussions about the nature of intelligence, consciousness, and the potential capabilities of AI systems. It remains a significant concept in the ongoing development and ethical considerations of AI technology. Now let's analyze how the Turing test actually works. The Turing test involves a human judge engaging in a text-based conversation with both a human and a machine without knowing which is which. The judge asks a series of open-ended questions on various topics ranging from everyday matters to more complex subjects. The judge evaluates their answers based on qualities like coherence, relevance, contextual understanding, and human-like reasoning. The machine's responses are expected to demonstrate not just pre-programmed reactions, but an ability to understand nuances, humor, and subtleties in the conversation. If after a series of interactions the judge cannot reliably distinguish the machine from the human based on their responses, the machine is considered to have passed the test. This means the machine has successfully mimicked human-like thought processes and communication skills to a degree that it is indistinguishable from a human interlocutor. The Turing test challenges AI developers to go beyond simple programmed responses and create machines capable of more sophisticated, adaptable, and human-like interaction. The test underscores the importance of developing AI that can not only perform tasks, but also engage in meaningful and contextually appropriate dialogue with humans. Now let's see some practical examples where the Turing test is used. The Turing test has inspired numerous examples and applications in the field of artificial intelligence, particularly in the development of conversational agents and chatbots. Early AI programs like Eliza and Perry were designed to simulate human conversation and were among the first to be evaluated using Turing test principles. Modern applications include sophisticated AI systems like OpenAI's GPT-3, which can generate human-like text and engage in complex dialogues. These technologies are widely used in customer service, virtual assistants, and interactive entertainment, where the ability to mimic human conversation enhances user experience. The Turing test also plays a crucial role in AI research, serving as a benchmark for measuring progress in machine intelligence and guiding the development of AI systems that can seamlessly interact with humans. And lastly, let's look at the criticisms and limitations of the Turing test. The Turing test, while influential, has faced significant criticisms and limitations. Critics argue that the test measures only a machine's ability to imitate human conversation, not true understanding or consciousness. A machine could pass the Turing test by manipulating language patterns without genuinely comprehending the content, thus achieving a superficial form of intelligence. Additionally, the test focuses solely on verbal communication, ignoring other forms of intelligence such as emotional, spatial, and creative abilities. Some philosophers like John Searle with his Chinese Room argument suggest that passing the Turing test does not equate to actual thought or understanding. Furthermore, the test's binary nature, pass or fail, oversimplifies the complex spectrum of intelligence. As AI technology advances, there is a growing recognition that new, more nuanced benchmarks are needed to evaluate machine intelligence comprehensively beyond the constraints of the Turing test. In conclusion, the Turing test remains a seminal concept in the field of artificial intelligence, serving as both a historical benchmark and a catalyst for ongoing debates about machine intelligence and human cognition. While it has inspired significant advancements in AI, the test's limitations highlight the complexity of truly understanding and replicating human intelligence. As technology continues to evolve, new metrics and methodologies will be needed to more accurately assess the capabilities and consciousness of AI systems. Nonetheless, the Turing test legacy endures, encouraging continual exploration and innovation in the quest to bridge the gap between human and artificial minds. This concludes our video. If you enjoyed it, consider subscribing to our channel and liking the video. Feel free to also check out our other videos on related topics. Thank you for watching.